Today on Mike Attempts, DIY drill press jackshaft. I wanted a drill press that would be good for both wood and metal, but I couldn't pass up this American-made Delta DP220. Problem is, the slowest speed is 680 RPM, which is too fast for drilling larger diameter holes in fixed steel. I've seen some great homemade jack shafts on the internet, but they all require the use of a lathe, which I do not have. So, I decided to improvise. The inside diameter of the column pipe is 2.5 inches, so I started by cutting a hole in 3/4 inch plywood using a 2 5/8 inch hole saw. The end result was this 2.5 inch wooden disc that fits perfectly into the top of the column. I cut out 3 more wooden discs using another piece of plywood underneath to prevent chip out. Next, I used a 3 inch hole saw to cut out a thin metal disc. I drilled 3 holes in the metal disc in order to secure it to the wooden discs. I used those holes to temporarily secure the metal disc so I could cut out a 1 inch hole in the center. After cleaning up the edges with a file, the metal disc doesn't look too bad. Next, I cut a 1 inch hole in the center of 2 of the 4 wooden discs. I bought 2 shaft collars with an outside diameter of 1 inch and an inside diameter of 9/16. Now they fit perfectly into the wooden disc. I drilled pilot holes for 3 inch screws in all 4 wooden discs. I enlarged the screw holes in the metal disc so the screw heads would sit flush. Here's how it'll go together. 2 wooden discs on the bottom, followed by a spacer to prevent the pulley from sitting too low. The 2 wooden discs with the 1-inch centers go on next. Drop in the shaft collars and top it off with the metal disc. The shaft on the 4-step pulley assembly I purchased has a diameter of 9/16 and slides right in. Time to glue it and screw it. Go easy on the wood glue. You only need a thin layer between each disc. I used a 1/4-inch drill bit to keep the spacer centered. Make sure the pilot holes are lined up and drive in the wood screws. Wipe off the excess glue inside and out before inserting the shaft collars. Once the glue was dry, I hit it with a light coat of primer and paint. Drop it down into the top of the column, make sure everything is fully seated, and slide in the pulley assembly. I decided to go with this adjustable link belt instead of traditional V-belts. You just stick one of the link ends through the hole and twist to lock it in place. Make sure you flip the motor pulley upside down before attaching the second belt. I was able to make both belts with a 5-foot section of link belt and still had a bit left over. The new slowest speed is somewhere around 300 RPM, which will be great for thick steel. Here's a side-by-side, before and after comparison, slowed down to 1/5 the actual speed. See the description below for the parts and tools I used. Feel free to rate this video, add your comments and questions below, and subscribe for more.